Welcome to week 7 of the Joe Reich Show. I'm your host, Ryan Brown, along with Wingate football head coach Joe Reich. The Bulldogs back on the road in the South Atlantic Conference in week 7 at Brevard. A big halftime deficit, but the Bulldogs come back and win 44-37. Coach, never seemed like there was any panic in your football team. Great comeback on the road in the South Atlantic Conference. Any win on the road is a good one.
Yeah, absolutely.
Just happy to get that one out of the way.
Yeah, and it was a tough team. Brevard came in, did a nice job early, got up on us early, had a nice game plan going in, and took advantage of us making a few errors early in the game and got us down early. But again, like you said, not a lot of panic in our guys. It's the advantage of having an older team that has been in that situation before and knew how to handle it.
Well, you know, with the big deficit at times in that game, you can think maybe there's a panic on the sideline, maybe have to throw the ball too much, but Nelson comes up with his biggest rushing total of the year, buck 53 on the ground. To your staff's credit, you didn't panic and still gave him the ball and really made a difference.
And we felt like we were moving the ball early. We just turned it over in the red zone a couple times. Then we got the score right before half, and we had moved it right down there the drive before and just had kind of not taken advantage of it. So we moved it back down again with 50 seconds to go or whatever. We score. We know we're going to get the ball to start the second half. We talked to the staff, look, there's no reason to change. Our guys on offense are playing well. Let's just keep doing what we're doing and come out and just do a great job in the second half.
Well, they had a lot of yards in that first half, but, you know, like the Carson Newman game, you shut them down in the second half. Brevard kind of same way. Two touchdowns. One of them was late in that second half. You know, we'll talk about it during the film, but what was some of the differences for this team after a half against an option offense?
Well, I think you see it. You see the speed of it. You see what they're doing. And at that point, you know, they've kind of run through their series of plays of what they can run through. So you get to the point where, all right, we've seen everything we're going to see. So now let's just get used to it. They were still moving it, but, you know, at that point we're starting to contain it. We're starting to control it. And hopefully it'll help us going into this week as well because we face another option team.
We'll take a look at the first half highlights. And Wingate's made a living out of comebacks this year. Once again, the team on the other side of the football coach scores first. Brevard in their first drive. There's a 2-yard run, then they get a little 5-yard run. Third down, big play for 9 yards, and then the big 51-yarder. Talk about that play.
The kid just did a nice job here. You know, they cut us on the flank, did a nice job of that all day and getting our guys down just a good effort. Jeter has got some speed back there.
Yeah, the option outside worked pretty good for Carson Newman, and first time for Brevard it works. Jeter in that slot back goes for 51 yards. And then first and goal at the 1. Bryce, who had 4 touchdowns on the day, there's his first. So Brevard takes a 7-0 lead. You guys go 3 plays and a punt. So Brevard gets the ball back. But, Coach, they go 3 plays and a punt. That third down is short, ending on a great play by Jack Taylor.
A great play. And Jack's been playing well, did a nice job for us.
Here's the play out to the right side. He gets off that lineman tackle. I mean, that's what makes the play successful. You get by that first edge. You know, the play works, but not here for Jack.
Right. Just great pursuit, great hustle. All out in that effort there by Jack.
So your team gets the ball back. We pick up the drive at the 38 after a holding penalty. Here's first down and 16. Nelson goes up the middle for 14 yards. And he maybe one of his best games of the season. Just his vision was so good. A lot of cutbacks. Great job. Here's Halfley to Floyd. Want this one back. Just a little bit behind.
And this was kind of a precursor of things to come in terms of that pattern. We hit that later in the game for several big plays, but unfortunately just weren't able to connect there. That may have even been 6 on that one.
Nelson on third down gets 2 yards. He needed 2, and then here's another nice play right up the middle. Gets a little shoestring tackle there. Would have liked him to get a couple more yards in the end zone because here's his first lost fumble of 2010, and credit, you saw the pop came in there, ball popped out.
Yeah, they did a nice job here stripping it out. He Nelson trying to make a few too many things happen there. He told me that after the game, I was just trying to make too much happen and should just put my shoulder down, put my head down and run.
So Brevard in the middle of a 10-play drive. Here's the 7th play. Jeter, again, the outside, gets 11 yards. Then Crumbaker up the middle. And Bryce again, Coach, he is about as tough as they come. Yeah. Breaking tackles, gets in there for 9 yards.
Yeah, I tell you what, he did a great job in this game, no doubt about it.
We'll pick up the next Wingate drive, trailing 13-2. We talked about the blocked extra point, taken back for 2 points on the return. First play, Woods goes up the middle.
Again, thumping up in there. You know, it's nice to have a guy that's got so many carries under his belt. You know, what a great veteran player he's been for us. And we know in critical situations we can go to him, he can get it done.
Yeah, Tylan was really impressed with Mark's blocking on Saturday. Here's a big play for him, 20 yards, his biggest catch in his career so far.
Absolutely, and this kid's just going to keep getting better and better and better. We're very fortunate. We've got a couple good young tight ends, plus we've got another one that we're redshirting this year that we feel like our future at that position is really, really good at this point.
So Halfley drops back and sacked here. Coach, some problem with the offensive line, giving up a couple sacks in the game, but only one in the game. This was the one right here, and forced you back into a third and 24. Halfley got 8 yards on a scramble, and here's the fourth down play, and Bowden, one of his drops, and disappointment for him.
Yeah, and you know, Chris is a great competitor, and he obviously was more disappointed than anybody in that, and you know, but he's a great player, great competitor, and you know, we're looking forward to great things from him as he continues to mature and get better.
Brevard, one of their trademark drives, 17 plays, 65 yards, but it ends right here. Great job to strip the football. We gave Brandon Mays, our defensive player of the game, had a forced fumble and a fumble recovery, and good job here to fall on this play.
Absolutely. Chasing it from the backside, did a nice job of just hustling to the ball. Good things happen when you hustle to the ball.
So Wingate gets the first turnover against Brevard, and looks more like Wingate football here, Coach. First play of the drive, 12 yards to Perry. We'll look at it twice. Next yard play was 28 yards, so good gains and marching right down the field.
And that's the way it felt on the field. Like, okay, bang, bang, here we go. We had been moving it already, but we had bogged down in the red zone, and you know, that's the way we're feeling here. Like, okay, we got this thing rolling. Now we're good to go. You know, and it really felt like, okay, here, this is, and again, this is the same throw that we missed earlier to Perry. We hit this a couple times later on in the game as well.
The first time this season, Woods has 10 or more runs over 10 yards. And here's one for 19 yards all the way down to the Brevard 29. So you go 12 yards, 28 yards, and 19 yards. But next play, Cody's only mistake of the day. Here's the interception.
It just a you know little high, little high on the throw, and again, you know, fortunately for Brevard, they're in the right spots and make the pick, and unfortunately stops our drive.
Yeah, and Brevard three plays later on fourth down and one from the Wingate 38, just a medium range. You expected them to go for it with this offense. Bryce,
sure,
dive up the middle of 38.
That was a tough exchange right there, going from hey, we think we're going to score, and yeah, we finally got it rolling to oh, they're up 20-2 at that point.
But your team comes right back. Here's an 18-yard pass to Perry Floyd down to the Brevard 27. You call a timeout there and come out with a Nelson Woods run. And then Cody goes incomplete. Just good job just to get rid of it. And then obviously, my mind, biggest play of the game up to this point easily. Here's Phil Thomas for 4.
Absolutely. And this is just, you know, again, if we said this before, this is just great players making great plays. You know, between Cody and Phil, that's a lot of experience there, a lot of playmaking. He did a great job. And You find a way to get open, and Cody seeing that's a tough look all the way back across the field, and not necessarily textbook throwing it back there, but again, just a great job by the two of them just working with one another.
Yeah, just a little slight wave there by Phil Thomas to get Cody's attention.
Yep.
So that touchdown score with 5 seconds left in the first half. Before that drive, we're thinking punt, fumble, turnover and downs, interception in your 4 drives. I mean,
right,
about
right,
as bad as it could get,
right,
but thankfully you get that touchdown, and Brevard did score get that touchdown to go up 20-2 with a minute left, and
right,
you guys scored in 55 seconds. Clutch drive.
Absolutely, and that was huge. And we felt like we could do that. We felt like we could get that ball rolling, and obviously it was the first of 6 drives that we scored there. So we knew we were moving the ball. There was no changes to be made. It was just, okay, let's just be consistent with what we're doing and just focus in and get it done. And fortunately, we were able to do that.
If you're going to have a turnover, you know, at a point in the field, a fumble inside the 20, an interception in the 30. So like you said, at least you're moving the football. At least we're
right,
not giving the ball away inside our own 20.
Right.
You know, we
right,
were all over their side of the field the whole first half.
And that's the way we felt. We came out of it like, okay, I think there was a lot of frustration and a lot of, boy, what are we doing? What's going on here? But the reality is, okay, look, guys, just calm down. We're moving the ball. Just eliminate a couple negative plays, and we'll be able to get in the end zone. And, you know, defensively, we'll make some adjustments. We'll be fine. Come out at halftime, we get the ball, we're good to go.
Well, Wingate, as we told you, they've been fighting back all year long.